Everyone can be better, like the session can be better. ओके सो गुड मॉर्निंग. सो आज का जो हमारा सेशन है उसके लिए हमने खुशी मैम को इनवाइट किया है. खुशी मैम हैज बीन एसोसिएटेड विथ एक्चुएटर्स सिंस अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम. ओके उन्होंने सारा जो ट्रेनिंग है वो भी एक्चुएटर से ही किया है एंड नाउ शी इज बेसिकली हेल्पिंग द स्टूडेंट्स आउट. तो बेसिकली शी इज वर्किंग एज वेल एज वो हमारे स्टूडेंट्स को हेल्प भी कर रही है. शी इज मेंटरिंग अवर स्टूडेंट्स फॉर CM1 एज वेल एज CB1 एंड CB2 का जो 1-to-1 मेंटरिंग है वो भी खुशी मैम कर रही है. तो उनका जो फीडबैक है स्टूडेंट्स से वो भी बहुत अच्छा है. तो आज हमारा जो टॉपिक का सेशन है वो हम मैम से ये जानेंगे कि मैम का जो एक्सपीरियंस रहा है 1-to-1 मेंटरिंग से, तो क्यों एक बच्चे को CB1 एंड 2 लेना चाहिए, कब लेना चाहिए एंड कैसे लेना चाहिए, एंड व्हाट इज द बेस्ट वे टू क्रैक CB1 एंड 2, उसको किसी के साथ दे सकते हैं क्या. सो मैम इज देयर टू आंसर ऑल योर क्वेरीज. ओके तो सबसे पहले खुशी मैम वेलकम टू अवर टॉक शो एंड इंट्रोड्यूस योर सेल्फ. सबसे पहले आप अपने बारे में बताइए.
Thank you so much, sir, for the warm welcome. So, hi everyone. A very good morning to all of you. My name is Khushi Agarwal, and I have currently been working in the life insurance industry for the past 2 years. I have cleared 8 out of 13 papers as of now, and I have been mentoring and teaching students CM1 and CB1 and CB2 with sir, and it has been a very good experience. And for the mentoring, the CB1 and CB2, I have realized that a lot of students join mentoring sessions not because they have a lot of doubts in the topic or the studying, but also because they are very anxious and they are not able to understand how to manage the subject with any other subject that they are pairing it with. Because generally, when you see CB1 and CB2, people pair it with either CS or CM papers, or they give both CB1 and CB2 together in one diet. So, main problem with the students is how to tackle both of these subjects together, or how to tackle either CB1 and CB2 with one CMCS papers. So they are very anxious, or if they are not able to clear one paper in one attempt, they want to basically know what should be the revision strategy, what should be the strategy to study. So that is the main doubt that I see students are facing these days, apart from the, of course, MCQs and other correlated subject doubts.
Okay. खुशी हम लोग एक एक करके आएंगे. सबसे पहले CB1 पे आएंगे, तो आप हमें ये बताइए कि CB1 कोई कितने टाइम में कर सकता है एंड क्या क्या चैलेंजेस आ सकते हैं CB1 में.
So I think minimum for CB1, you will need at least 2 months of preparation. And if you have more, of course, you can give along with the other papers. Main challenges that students face in CB1 is the application-based questions, I think, because IFOA especially and IAI as well, if you see that they have stopped giving direct theory related questions, because of course online exams are there, open book is there for IFOA, so they will never give you direct theory related questions, but they will check your basic concepts are clear or not. For that, you will have to be very clear regarding everything that you are studying, because everything will be application based. And students face a lot of doubts in case study based questions that are 20 markers questions in exams, because they don't know how to interpret that question, that scenario, as per the theory that they have asked. So main trick there is to use keywords and to connect your theory that you have read with the scenario that they have given. So very small thing, if they have written that there is a company that is working in a developed country or a developing country, so make sure you're highlighting everything and basically customizing your answer to that very point, that this particular company is in a developed country. So you have to write some points for that also, that being in a developed country, what should be the circumstances that the company is working in, or if it is a developed. So small points you have to consider. And one more thing is the problems in MCQs. So what I feel is students face a lot of problems in MCQs, because sometimes they will feel all the 4 options that has been given is either correct, or all of those are either wrong. So the trick here is to either use elimination method, wherein you are taking one option individually and finding out reasons why this won't be the correct answer. Or suppose a very basic, if there is a question that which of the following options will lead to a decrease in demand of, suppose, residential properties. And if you feel all of the 4 options will lead to a decrease in demand, then your approach to correct answer should be which among the 4 options will lead to a decrease in demand to a very low amount. So basically the quantification, that it will lead to a very negligible decrease in demand. So that should be the correct answer. So the approach should be choosing the best out of all the four correct or choosing the worst out of all the four wrong, depending on the question. So that should be the approach.
Okay, that was really nicely answered. So can you just tell us from your experience that a brief preparation strategy, agar koi humse training le raha hai ya fir agar koi self mein kar raha hai, to how should they go about the syllabus of CB1 and kab kya kya khatam karna chahiye?
So I think first you should always start with, if you have taken coaching, so you should start with the lectures, and then you should go ahead and start reading the co-reading along with the lectures. After you have done that, please finish all of the revision notes, which are basically chapter-wise past paper questions divided. But a problem with this is, when you start doing revision notes, you will feel a bit confident because all of the chapters are divided. Like, you know that this question is from these chapters only. In exam, what happens? Some people are not able to understand what question is exactly from which chapter, because it is very difficult to identify an exam. So for that, after making revision notes, you should go ahead and solve the past papers. And that also you should focus on the recent term. I think 2019 onwards, when the pattern changed, because earlier it was very theory related. So doing application based questions will help you a lot, which is the recent term mock papers. And after solving all of this, if you have time, you should solve the X assignments. And you should also focus more on the application-based questions, for which the approach should be, you are reading the question and then you are trying to find your own points and keywords to that answer. Why? Because if you just read the question and then go ahead directly read the answer, you will feel that, okay, you know these points, you can write an exam. But to sit idle and think of those points on your own is the main difficult task that people don't do. People don't sit and write and practice. They will just read the past papers or the revision notes and feel that, okay, these points I would be able to think in exam. But when you just sit in exam directly, you are blank because you've not practiced that way. So I think that should be the approach. I think in both CB1 and CB2, for the application based questions, you should sit and make yourself think of all the points that you can generate for those specific questions.
Tell us some of the key highlights of CB2 exam. Like, CB2 exam, बहुत लोग बोलते हैं एकदम easy है, ऐसे ही हो जाता है. So basically, इस myth को break करने के लिए, what all are your pro tips and how can we basically clear CB2 in first attempt?
So students or people who say that CB2 is very easy and they can like do it without studying, I don't think that is correct at all. I will never vouch for that. So the main trick, like I have seen in CB2, people first of all will take it very lightly because they will either pair it with some main paper and they will leave it for the end. They will focus on the main CMCS papers. They will study everything. And I have people who will tell me that I have just 1 month left for exam and I've not even started with CB. So how do I cover everything in 1 month? So generally your approach should be 1 month for revision. You should not be studying or completing your syllabus in the last 1 month. So start early. Don't take anything lightly when any professional exam, because it is not easy. You will have to give your best and you will have to study. Don't take it lightly and don't think somebody has said that you don't need to read and they just passed in 1 week of studying, so you will also be able to do that. Because people are different. People's learning ability, thinking skills, everything is different. They might be people who are very good in studies and they were able to crack, but you might not be able to. And see,
like, sorry to interrupt you, इसमें एक और चीज जो मैटर करता है कि उनका क्या बैकग्राउंड है. अगर कोई इकोनॉमिक्स ऑनर्स बैकग्राउंड से अगर बीकॉम का बच्चा है, फिर साइंस का बच्चा अपने आप को उससे कंपेयर करेगा, so that is the biggest problem I feel in CB level exams.
Yes, yes. So if you have economics background, it will help you a lot. Of course, things are very complex in CB2 as compared to 12th syllabus, but then again, you have a background to start with. But people who are coming from non-economics background, you have to first build your basics on which you have to build your further understanding. And one more thing that I've seen, people ignoring graphs altogether in CB2 because they feel online exam is, so graphs won't come. I don't have to draw it from scratch, so I'll just ignore it completely. But I think concepts will be clear only when you are able to understand each and every graph, all the lines, all the points, every particular label in the graph. So don't just ignore graphs altogether, because they might not give you to draw it because it is an online exam, but they might give you the graphs and you have to interpret it. And you will not be able to do that unless your concepts are clear. This will also help you in writing questions, because if your concepts are clear, I think if you read all of the graphs together of CB2 combined, half of your question you can revise via graphs. It is that important. So my just tip will be, don't just ignore graphs and focus on understanding each and every graph. It might look complex in starting, but if you build your knowledge on those graphs, it will be very helpful in your concept clearance and also help you in case study based questions as well.
जी एक बात बताओ, जैसे अभी आप इतना पेन ले रहे हो, आप पूरा दिन ऑफिस करते हो, आप अपना yes. पढ़ते हो, और इसके बाद में भी लाइक व्हेन आई अप्रोच यू फॉर सीबी वन एंड टू मेंटरिंग, यू वर लाइक यस सर आई एम गोइंग टू डू इट विदाउट इवन आस्किंग फॉर द पे एंड एवरीथिंग, दैट इज ऑलवेज सेकेंडरी फॉर यू सिंस द टाइम यू हैव जॉइंड अस. सो व्हाट इज द मोटिवेशन बिहाइंड इट, एंड हमारा जो ऑब्जेक्टिव है जो मैंने आपके साथ शेयर किया था, सो बेसिकली हम लोग वो वन टू वन मेंटरिंग में क्या कर रहे हैं, वो एक बच्चे को क्यों बुक करना चाहिए और वो उसको क्या हेल्प होगा, सब ये बताओ.
ओके, सो एक्चुअली दिस इज वेरी पर्सनल, बिकॉज इफ आई टेल ऑल ऑफ यू, द फर्स्ट पेपर आई गेव वाज CM1, एंड यू सर आल्सो नोज दैट ड्यू टू अ टेक्निकल ग्लिच आई वाज नॉट एबल टू सबमिट दैट पेपर, एंड दैट वाज अ वेरी हार्ड टाइम फॉर मी, एंड इट वाज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर मी टू कोप अप विद इट. एंड इनिशियली ऑल्सो व्हेन आई बिगन एट चिल्ड्रन साइंस बिफोर you know, taking tuition from sir and ma'am, I did not have anyone with whom I could discuss or I could, you know, say ki, I have these problems, how to tackle this. So main objective for this mentoring was that I faced that problem. I don't want others to face that problem. So maybe if I can help in any way possible, I will do that. And as I said, a lot of people don't join for specific doubt clearance. They join for this mentoring that someone can guide me how to revise, how to study, how to make my syllabus, how to make my timetable so that I can complete these papers. So I think if somebody with an experience of 8 papers, and I've been giving exams in, I think, 4 years, 3-4 years. So I think if I'll be able to help students, that will be a very good thing. And a student with any particular doubt should join this session. You of course have the forum where you can post if you don't want to give the time. But then again, if you are not able to understand at least even one line in the code reading, just highlight it, make a compilation of all of the doubts you have, book a session. And when I have the time, suppose 15 minute session of each mentoring, but if I have time between the sessions, I don't see that 15 minutes is over and that now you have to go because your time is up. If you need 30 minutes with me and another student is not coming, then I will give you that 30 minutes. I will not see that, okay, 15 minutes is up, there's a clock and then you have to go. I don't see the time when I'm just discussing and guiding you. So I think if you need any kind of guidance, I can see some familiar faces on the call also from past papers, but I've not seen you guys on mentoring. So you're very welcome. And if you want to join, and you will always feel good after joining, and you will always feel that some, because I've mentored some people in the few past weeks only when they were very anxious. And after the session ended, they told me, okay, now I'm feeling better because I think now I'll be able to study better. So my point is that some people are very anxious that what will happen in exam. But a teacher always told me that examination is not just a test of your knowledge, but also a test of your nerves. Because if you have studied very good for past 6 months, but on the exam day you are panicking and you get blank, what is the point of studying hard for 6 months? Because you're not able to put that on paper. And nobody is going to ask you, how did you prepare? They are just going to see your result. They're not going to see your hard work for the past 6 months. For any paper, for any exam, they just see the result, which is pass or fail. That's it. It's a black and white thing.
So basically, I hope so, सबको ये हमारा objective clear है कि basically it's not only for academic doubts, अगर आप training ले रहे हो CB1 and 2 का, and it's always जो ma'am ने जो बताया कि it's not only about कि भाई आपको कोई academic doubt है, वो तो भाई आप recorded lecture से, और जब doubt class होगा शिवांगी ma'am का, नेहा ma'am का, and अंकित sir का, संचेति sir का, तो आप उसमें पूछ सकते हो. बट ये जो मेंटरिंग है बेसिकली वो जो एक जो होता है ना कि यार मेरा इतना हुआ है, अब मेरे को गाइड करो यहाँ से कि कितना, दैट इज वेयर द वन टू वन मेंटरिंग कम्स इनटू पिक्चर. इट्स मोर अबाउट योर प्लानिंग, योर डायरेक्शन, योर पाथवे, कि भाई मेरे को इतना, ये कोई नहीं बता सकता कि यार आपका, उसके लिए वही बता सकता है जो वो चीज कर रहा है, एंड बेसिकली जो आपको सुन सके. लाइक बींग वेरी ऑनेस्ट, एक क्लास जिसमें 100 लोग बैठे हैं तो मैं इंडिविजुअल लेवल पर उतना नहीं सुनता हूँ कि भाई मेरे को अभी से बताओ, तो वहां पर आप अपना पर्सनल चीज बता सकते हो कि मेरा इतना हुआ है एंड मैं इसके आगे और कैसे बढ़ूं. एक और जो क्वेश्चन है, उसके बाद हम लोग डाउट्स लेंगे थोड़ा बच्चों का. एक और जो क्वेश्चन है मेरा वो ये है कि आप मेरे को ये बताओ, लोग बोलते हैं इजी है, एंड ठीक है कंपेयर टू CMCSE इजी है भी, बट स्टिल आप देखो रिजल्ट 100% नहीं आ रहा है, इसका रीजन क्या है? मतलब
रीजन प्राइमरिली विल बी पीपल टेक इट लाइटली, पीपल डोंट स्टडी वेल बिकॉज इन सपोज इन स्कूल ऑल्सो वेन यू थॉट दैट ओके इंग्लिश इज वेरी इजी आई डोंट हैव टू स्टडी, यू स्कोर द लीस्ट मार्क्स इन इंग्लिश बिकॉज यू टेक इट लाइटली. सो द प्राइमरी थिंग इज डोंट टेक इट लाइटली. हायर पेपर्स वेर आई हैव सीन स्टूडेंट्स अपियरिंग फॉर CP3, CP2 एंड टेलिंग दैट ओके आई स्टडीड फॉर जस्ट 1 week एंड आई क्लियर द एग्जाम. But I've also seen people who have not cleared the exam even after giving it thrice. So there is both sides to the coin. So don't compare yourself with anyone because all of the individual circumstances will be different. Don't take any paper lightly and manage your time well between two subjects if you're giving it together. Don't prioritize one onto other. Because in Excel also, if you see CM papers, people will just take Excel lightly. But that will only lead you to failure. Because sometimes Excel or R papers will save you. So similarly, CB1, CB2, you should not take lightly. And you should not like read core reading. People will read the entire core reading and feel that their syllabus is over. They have read everything. But unless and until, as I said, you practice the case studies, the scenario-based questions, will not be able to generate points in exams. If you don't sit and make yourself think of those new points, you will not be able to answer. So those are the things people focus on book work knowledge and don't understand the application aspect of these papers. So these two things are, I think, the primary thing which leads to less pass percentage in CB papers because people will underestimate this and will focus on the book work knowledge but not on the application based part of it. So I think those should be the primary focus.
Okay, so now we are opening the house for some questions. Khushi, if you can just see the chat box, like we can take around 4 to 5 queries. If you can just read and answer them. Yes, the recording will be available. So Sunny Goyal is having a query. If you can read and just answer.
Yes, so he's asking many solutions of IAI past papers MCQs are incorrect. How do we tackle that? So Sunny, as I said, if the question in exam is like if the question is somehow incorrect in the exam in which you are appearing for and you feel that this is incorrect, you just don't leave it blank. That is the first point. In exam, you mark what you think is the best as per your understanding. And if the question is actually incorrect, there will be, of course, some kind of a decision made for the marking of that question. And this question, this problem will be faced by all of the students appearing for exams. And while practicing, if you're finding out that there are some solutions where answers are incorrect, so then of course you can mark it as per your understanding. And if you have any doubt wherein you are also not able to understand, then of course you can raise that as a doubt with us. But as I said, you will always feel that all of the four options are either correct or incorrect. So the approach should be to find out the most correct out of those. So that should be the approach when dealing with MCQs.
Okay, any more questions which anyone is having they want to ask? Ma'am is available for the next 2 minutes. If anyone is having any query.
Okay. Ishika has asked, only 12-13 days left for CB2 exam. What should be our approach in these last days? So, see, this again depends on what all till you have covered till now, right? But then the basic approach before 15 days of exam should be revision and focusing on application-based questions, the past papers of recent terms starting from April 24th and then going backwards. So you should focus on those application-based questions. And if you are slow in typing, practice typing so that you finish your paper on time and sit and write the 20 marks scenario-based questions, sit and write and practice a lot of MCQs for CB2, especially because weightage is more. So practice a lot of MCQs, practice the scenario-based questions in the last 12-13 days. And if you feel that any one particular section or chapter of the course you are weak in, so focus on that on the last days. Where you think you have not studied enough and you are facing difficulties because you find that particular chapter difficult. So focus on those. Now, any suggestions on how to prepare for MCQs for IAI? So just that elimination method, practice a lot and try to find out the best out of all the four correct answers or the worst out of all the incorrect answers that you feel. So you have to again practice a lot to maintain that accuracy in MCQs. How to revise using graphs for the CB2 exam. So there are certain topics wherein graphs are very important. For CB2, if you say when tariffs are imposed or when taxes are imposed? What are the changes in demand and supply? How will the imports reduce? How will the domestic supply increase? So all of these, so you can basically compile all of the graphs together, or you can go topic wise and focus on the graphs one by one. And if you have any doubt in the graph, make sure you're clearing that. Because if you're not understanding the graphs, which means your concepts are not clear, and that will be very problematic in your exams. Next. Do we need to give reference in CB1 too? Part, I think you have to give reference for anything that you are taking from the co-reading material. But again, if there are application-based questions, then I don't think you need to give referencing because you're generating points on your own. Okay?
Yes, Rohit, you can give FRM and CM1 together. No problem in that. You can basically manage both.
And Vibha, of course, you can start CB1 now and you will be able to complete till November. You have 2 full months, September and October. Can you suggest? Yes, sir.
Anushree is having a query. Anushree, yes. Gupta.
How to study CB2? Because I find it very difficult to write an answer. So I think, again, you are referring here to the scenario-based question where you have to think of the answers and write. Key is to first read some past papers to understand that there is a pattern and flow of answers. So you will understand how other people are writing the answers and you will get that flow. When that flow comes in, sit with a paper and try to generate points on your own. If your concepts are clear and if you have read those past papers wherein you know the pattern of answering, then you will be able to generate points on your own and write the answer. So the key is just practice and practice. Practice writing and not just reading. Strategy to prepare for exam. Yes, sir?
We can take the last query. Jia Shah.
Yes. Strategy to prepare for exam for the next 20 days. Yes, Jia. So again, keep revising. Keep focusing on the weak areas that you have, where you feel that you have not prepared enough. And suppose if you have given mocks and you are securing less marks in certain particular chapters, focus there. Practice the past papers, recent ones starting from April 2024. And then focusing on the, for CB1, you can focus on MCQs. You can focus on certain chapters that you think like there are, it's basically micro, macro, and then the School of Economics, right? So basically you have to focus on all, like you have to see chapters as a compilation of certain things. Like you have to divide the chapters as certain sections and not just individual chapters, because they will combine 4-5 chapters and give you a long sum. So focus on that, wherein you are able to recognize that, okay, this question is from that chapter. So that will again come from practice.
Okay. Yeah, you can take one more.
Yes. So Nancy is asking, if I do self-study for CB1, what should be the approach? So self-studying for CB1, you should start with reading the co-reading, solving all of the math questions that are there, then moving on to the exercises that are at the end of the co-reading material. Focusing on the past papers of recent terms and then trying to sit in an exam scenario and give mocks on your own so that you see where your position is, where are you standing, and what are the areas you should work on after giving the mock. You will understand where are you lacking it.
Okay. That was really amazing. Even after teaching for so many years, I got to know a few more points. So thank you so much. And I will request all of you ki aap log sab judiye 1-to-1 mentoring mein, because dekhi, you have basically paid for a service and hum log ko bhi, like when we discuss after 2-3 days ki kya update raha, to ma'am humko yehi bolti hai ki koi book hi nahi kar raha hai, do hi book ho raha hai, teen hi book ho raha hai. So बेसिकली वी आर देयर टू हेल्प यू. आपको ये रिकॉग्नाइज करना पड़ेगा, आप बस खाली क्या है, आप सही जगह पे उस चीज को हिट नहीं कर रहे हो. व्हाट योर एटीट्यूड इज कि भाई हम सर को डायरेक्ट मैसेज कर दे, बट देयर इज एन एक्सपर्ट फॉर दैट. सर कैन नॉट मैनेज एवरीथिंग अलोन, सर हैज अ टीम, तो वो आपको उस प्रोसेस के थ्रू जाने से आपको बेटर गाइडेंस मिल पाएगा. जहां सर आपको 5 सेकंड में ऐसे ही टाल देंगे, वहां मैम आपको पूरा प्रॉपर टाइम देके उस चीज को पूरा प्रॉपरली समझा सकती है. ठीक है, तो थैंक यू सो मच खुशी, थैंक यू सो मच. ओके,
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू एवरीवन फॉर जॉइनिंग,
थैंक यू,
बाय, हैव अ ग्रेट डे,
बाय.